It's AumSum time!
Why do our eyes become red?
Because we color them using red paint.
Oh, AumSum. Let me explain. Did you know that extremely tiny blood vessels are present on the surface of our eyes? Yes, they do. When these blood vessels get dilated or inflamed, our eyes appear red.
Oh.
In this condition, our red eyes are also sometimes referred to as bloodshot eyes. The most common causes of eye redness are allergies triggered due to irritants such as pollen, dust, perfume, or smoke. In this case, our eyes may also have itching, burning, or tearing. A condition called dry eye, in which our eyes lack the tears necessary to nourish or lubricate them. An infection such as conjunctivitis. Sometimes conjunctivitis is also referred to as pink eye. Finally, eye redness can also be a result of trauma or injury to our eyes. Why do our eyes twitch?
Because we use too much Twitter.
What? Oh, I'm sorry. Eye twitching is also referred to as eyelid twitching or myokymia. Myokymia is a repetitive, spontaneous, involuntary spasm or quivering of our eyelid muscles. These eye twitches are generally mild and last for a very short length of time. But in some cases, they may be strong enough to force closing of both the eyelids, and in some cases, they might last for a longer period of time. Eye twitches are considered to be unpredictable, as in they do not follow any specific pattern of occurrence. Some of the common causes of eye twitching are eye irritation, fatigue, lack of sleep, too much alcohol, caffeine, or tobacco, allergies, etc. Eyelid twitches are generally considered to be harmless, but may require a doctor visit in some extreme cases. Is rubbing your eyes good or bad?
Good. No bad. Maybe both.
Oh, AumSum. We usually rub our eyes due to lack of sleep, or to remove dust, irritants, etc. Now, sometimes rubbing our eyes for brief periods can be good because it activates the release of tears, which lubricate our eyes. Rubbing even stimulates the vagus nerve, which in turn slows down our heartbeat, helping relieve stress. However, don't make it a habit. Firstly, continuous rubbing can cause the outer layer of our eyes, called cornea, to get thin, weak, and conical in shape, causing a disease known as keratoconus, thus leading to distorted vision. Secondly, if there is an irritant and we try to remove it by rubbing, that irritant can end up scratching our cornea. Lastly, if people with glaucoma rub their eyes, it can lead to extra increase in fluid pressure, further damaging the optic nerve, eventually leading to blindness. Why do we get an eye sty?
Cause you don't wear cool shades.
No. Eye sty, or hordeolum, is a painful pimple-like bump near our eyelids. It is caused due to Staphylococcus bacterium, which lives harmlessly on our skin. Now, our eyelids contain three glands called gland of Zeiss, gland of Moll, and meibomian gland. Gland of Zeiss secretes an oily substance to lubricate our eyelashes. Gland of Moll is a sweat gland, while meibomian gland prevents the evaporation of our eyes' tear film. Now, sometimes in the above glands, dead skin cells and bacteria get trapped, leading to an infection, thus giving rise to a sty. Now, if infection occurs in the glands of Zeiss or Moll, it is called an external sty. However, if the infection occurs in meibomian gland, it is called an internal sty. Also, as an internal sty presses against our eye, it proves to be more painful than an external sty. Topic: human eyes. What are eye floaters?
They are worms.
No. Eye floaters are tiny spots or thread-like strands that drift in our field of vision. When we move our eyes and try to look at them directly, they seem to dart away.
Yeah, dude. I think they try to hide.
Nah.
Huh?
Oh.
When light from an object enters into our eyes, it passes through the vitreous humor to form an image on the retina. Vitreous humor is a clear gel-like substance. It is 99% water and 1% collagen fibers. These collagen fibers are spread evenly throughout the vitreous humor, but sometimes these fibers tend to come together forming clumps or strands. When we look at a clear sky or a blank page and the clumps or strands are very close to the retina, they cast a strong shadow on the retina, making them easily detectable in the clear background and thus forming eye floaters.